I feel very badly for Paul Manafort.
Were you shocked that he only got 47?
No, this criminal justice system can't surprise me anymore.
People commit white-collar crimes. They should be prepared to bring their toothbrush and spend as much time behind bars as anybody else.
You just can't treat people differently, not just based on race, but also based on the types of crimes that they commit.
Right.
That's wrong.
The reaction from President Trump and some of the 2020 Democratic field to former Trump campaign chair Paul Manafort, who was sentenced to less than 4 years in federal prison this week. The special counsel's office had recommended a longer prison term, up to 25 years. And while Manafort will be back in court on Wednesday for another sentencing hearing that could put him behind bars for years longer, did his sentence fit the crime? Let's bring in ABC News Chief Justice Correspondent Pierre Thomas, who has covered the special counsel's investigation from the start, and our own Terry Moran, senior national correspondent who covers the president and also the Supreme Court. Good morning. A lot of factors, Pierre, go into deciding this. The judge looks at a lot of different things. So what stood out to you in this case, especially with so many people complaining that the sentence was just too light?
Martha, as you can see, this has turned into a very intense debate about fairness in terms of the criminal justice system. The prosecutors had argued, basically, that Manafort is a straight-up criminal, that he had 30 overseas bank accounts with more than $55 million in it, and that he did not pay taxes on $6 million of it. They wanted him to get a significant prison term for that. The defense and Manafort himself made the case that, look, he's an older man, he's not in good health, and they believed that the sentence should be less. The judge said the sentencing guidelines, which called for 19 to 24 years in prison, the judge said excessive. Too much.
And just what Pierre's laid out there, Terry, and then we have the judge saying, this stood out, that Manafort lived an otherwise blameless life. That's clearly at odds with what Pierre just said.
With that and with a career that brought influence peddling to a level of intensity and disgrace in some ways that hangs over Washington. This is the guy who represented the dictator of Ukraine when he was slaughtering people in the streets of Kiev. This is the guy who took money from people like Jonas Savimbi and other gangsters around the world. Millions upon millions of dollars, stashed him in Cyprus and then engaged in tax evasion on an industrial scale, and faces sentencing on these other crimes. That is not an otherwise blameless life. Look, it's good that judges have discretion to look at the human being in front of them outside the guidelines and try to do justice. But that discretion tells us something about our system and about the individual judge.
Exactly, Pierre, and I want to talk about that, because several Democrats say the sentence reflects a criminal justice system that more harshly punishes people of color. One former federal prosecutor wrote, "The system isn't broken because Manafort got 4 years rather than the 19-year recommendation that the sentencing guidelines spat out. The system is broken because other people get the long sentence because other poorer and often darker people don't get the same chances."
Martha, let's take the emotion out of it and let's talk facts. There was a recent Justice Department, Sentencing Commission report that found that African-American males got a sentence of 19% higher time in prison than their white counterparts for the same crime. So this is a real issue. And the other thing I would just say about Manafort is this, the context. He was in jail during trial because he had been accused of and found by another judge of witness tampering. In jail for witness tampering. Also, the context of a person who made a deal with the prosecutors and then was caught lying. So this notion of otherwise blameless life was in, you know, contradiction to recent facts, many people would argue.
And so the lighter expected in this case, but he's got more sentencing this week. What do you expect there?
Well, I expect an answer in some ways from the judge in the District of Columbia. Look, this is something that strikes at the heart of confidence in our justice system, and that will not be lost on the next judge who sees the otherwise blameless Paul Manafort.
Will that judge look and say, hey, he didn't get enough time? I mean, it's certainly supposed to be separate.
It is, and will be separate, but the assessment of these crimes that this judge will sentence Manafort on in the context of a life, which now includes this sentence, is fair. And I don't see how any judge across the country, with the incarceration rates, the incarceration crisis in this country, which in part is a crisis about racism, can turn her head away from those issues.
And I want to turn to the Mueller probe here quickly, Pierre. We've all heard that the investigation may be coming to an end. I feel like we've heard that before. So what can you tell us about that?
Well, based on our sourcing, Mueller is nearing the end of his work. And we expect that in the coming days, he will turn over his confidential report to Attorney General Bill Barr. And then Barr will have one of the most momentous decisions that any attorney general has had in 30-some years, which is how much of that report is made public and turned over to Congress.
And do you have a sense of that?
You know, Barr has said during his confirmation hearing that he wants to be transparent, but he will abide by the standards of the Justice Department. That typically says where people aren't charged with crimes, that you don't do much talking about them. But there's so much in this investigation about the number of contacts between people associated with Trump and Russians that people will want to know, and how Mueller chose to deal with these issues.
And the big topic, of course, Terry, collusion. The president said there was no collusion, there was no collusion. There are hints that that's certainly what Mueller may have been looking at. How big a deal is it if they don't find collusion for the president?
Huge. He's cleared if Robert Mueller comes back. Mueller became a folk hero in the United States. Robert De Niro.
Even if he finds all sorts of things.
Sure. No, but the central and most serious question in this investigation, the reason Robert Mueller started it, is did the current president of the United States assist the Kremlin in an attack on our democracy? And if Mueller, after 2 years, comes back and says, I don't have the evidence to support that charge, that's a reckoning. That's a reckoning for progressives and Democrats who hoped that Mueller would essentially erase the 2016 election. It's a reckoning for the media. It's a reckoning around the country if, in fact, after all this time, there was no collusion.
Pierre?
Well, the fact is, if you look at all the charges so far, no one Mueller has charged so far has been charged with directly conspiring with the Russians. That's a fact. But the Mueller report is shrouded in secrecy. There's just a lot we don't know. And there are certain facts that Mueller has hinted to throughout the case, like the fact that Paul Manafort allegedly gave polling data to a suspected Russian intelligence officer, Roger Stone, a confidant of the president, communicating with one of the Russian hackers. So again, stay tuned. We have to see what the report says.
And Terry, even if there's nothing there, The Hill will start several investigations into all kinds of things.
That's right. There are certainly other investigations about the Trump businesses, about Trump Tower Moscow, which may draw the interest of prosecutors and congressional investigators. And certainly these issues need to be brought to light.
And how about the attention of the American public? If the Mueller, that's a question.
It is a question. In fact, Democrats have to worry that they don't look like they're just throwing anything against the wall and hope it'll stick, and get back to the old kind of politics. If they want to beat Donald Trump, beat him. Beat him on the issues, beat him in politics. Don't beat him with investigations.
Great to have your perspective this morning. Thanks for coming in, guys.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.